Presenting Madrokt and his revolutionary Senna support playstyle. While certainly being a solid League of Legends player, you wouldn't be wrong calling him heartstuck for the last 6 years. Very recently though, Madrokt finally managed to push himself into the solo queue master tier as he picked up Senna support after her latest buffs. Not Glacial Augment Senna, not Grasp of the Undying Senna, well, not even Lethality Senna, but Senna with the Keystone Guardian and Moonstone Renewer for her mythic item. The strategy wins games, and it wins a lot. In this video, you will learn exactly how the player Madrokt reinvented the support Senna metagame. Lean back and enjoy your League of Legends masterclass. The first thing you will notice when looking at Madrokt's Senna is that he has to be rather careful with his mana pool during the earlier stages of the laning phase. He takes neither Presence of Mind, nor Biscuit Delivery, nor Mana Flow Band in his runes, so all he has to work with is his base mana and the mana regeneration from his support item. Quite frankly, that's not much, so you have to be extremely cautious not to cast too many spells, as especially Senna's Q is very costly at 70 mana per cast at level 1. Obviously, you still make use of the mana you have by casting abilities and traits and poking your opponents with Q, but for the most part you should sit back and collect as many souls from minions as possible. Madrokt will never spend more than half of his mana pool while poking, so he always has all of his spells available for 2v2 fights or jungle ganks. And you can bet he loves to force 2v2s in lane. His rune page is designed to get as big an advantage as humanly possible in the early game, so he's looking to either force fights with his W or simply wait until his enemies get impatient and foolishly engage on him. In this clip, for example, you can see that Senna and Kai'Sa are baiting the enemy with their control ward, getting a clean engage and coming out massively ahead due to the combination of Guardian, Bone Plating and Revitalize. The resulting health loss for Tristana makes the lane phase unplayable for her and she has to completely forfeit any lane pressure. Note how Senna did not even need to use her ultimate here. In this other example, you can see what happens when the circumstances are not quite as optimal for Madrokt. He takes a lot of damage due to being somewhat over-aggressive, but Senna and Lucian still manage to come out cleanly on top thanks to Senna's streamlined early game runes. Keep in mind though that early plays like these are only possible if you manage your mana correctly. In this situation, Madrokt has not yet been able to go back to base a single time, which forces him to make smart decisions about his spell usage. After deliberately saving mana by not using his Q, he is able to cast a crucial ultimate to turn the fight around. Coming out ahead in situations like these during the lane phase is absolutely game-winning, as everything that happens afterwards is a snowball effect. Just imagine how differently this game would go if Madrokt had taken the minor rune Overgrowth instead of Revitalize. He would be dead, lacking the extra heal and shield power, his enemies would have earned the kill gold instead, and his teammates would probably be flaming him too. By the way, would you flame your teammates for playing an off-meta build like Guardian Senna, or would you be trusting them? Please, everyone feel free to be honest and write your truthful answer in the comments. After your first base though, you return to lane with Bantleglass Mirror, or at least Fairy Charm. Due to the extra mana regeneration, you now play the lane phase on easy mode, as you can spam your abilities much more freely. A regular Senna only uses Q to poke her lane opponents, but with the extra mana regeneration at his disposal, Madrokt can keep his lane partner and himself at max HP. All that early game power typically grants him complete lane control, which then allows him to roam and make plays in river and mid lane. Guardian Senna is undoubtedly extremely strong in early 2v2 fights, but surprisingly weak in 1v1 situations. You are lacking damage and cannot even trigger your keystone without an ally. See how Madrokt is roaming the river, being super careful and passive while by himself, but immediately switching into beast mode when near an allied champion. If your enemies are smart, they will not challenge your 2v2 potential, but submit to your lane dominance. However, this allows you to set up plays for your jungler around bot lane, leading to free objectives such as early game dragons. A true lose-lose situation for your opponents. A true win-win situation for you, however, would be to click the subscribe button if you enjoy educational League of Legends content like this. Anyway, even if your enemies try to play defensively, they still need to attend the minion wave, which enables you to potentially catch them with W and start a fight regardless. You are not invincible though, so make sure you know where the enemy jungler and mid laner are, and if their top laner could potentially turn the situation around with a teleport play. Speaking of ganks, the fact that Senna is very good at assisting your jungler is common knowledge, and this holds true even without the utility from Glacial Augment. You still get AoE heals off and can snare enemies with your W, while providing safety and utility with your E. From level 6 onwards though, Guardian Senna is an extremely dangerous enabler for tower dives. Not only is your ultimate's shield stronger than usual due to Revitalize and the extra ability power from Vandal Glass Mirror, but you can further apply the Guardian Shield from a distance by casting Q. Graves can go in here super early, not giving the enemy time to react, and still make it out alive due to all the extra survivability. The real craziness begins though after you complete your Moonstone Renewer. Madrockt also gets the rune Futures Market to complete this item as fast as possible, because if that happens during the early game, your lane opponents simply can't win anymore. In this clip, it looks like Madrockt would be at a major disadvantage as he is a full level down. However, due to his Moonstone Renewer power spike, they end up winning the 2v2 skirmish regardless. The Moonstone passive is super OP on Senna, as she affects both enemy and allied champions in combat all the time with basically all her abilities and even her massively ranged auto attack. Moreover, the extra health and ability power make you surprisingly tanky, which also leads to your enemies misjudging how long it would take to actually kill you. Note how Madrockt's team got caught pretty badly in this clip, yet he is getting away just barely due to the combination of health, ability power, and ability haste. This ultimately allows him to stay in the fight as long as he wants to, completely turning the situation around as his enemies chase him way too hard and end up overextended. Enchanter support champions are generally speaking extremely strong during the later stages of the game, and Moonstone Senna is not an exception. The fight you see right there is honestly nothing short of beautiful. Not only does the enemy fail to kill Senna because, once more, she is tankier than expected, but the combination of Moonstone Renewer and Senna's utility even denies the kill on Lucian. Just imagine how that Camille must be feeling right there, so close yet so far. Mind you, this is merely 15 minutes into the match, Senna hasn't even unlocked her true late game enchanter potential yet. Even with just Moonstone Renewer and nothing else, Senna is a monster in mid game teamfights. In this exchange right there, Madrockt gets 7 Moonstone triggers off, healing for a total of 746 health with just this mythic passive. On top of that, he boosts his team with his Guardian trigger, a 5-man ultimate, and multiple Q casts. The impact you have in teamfights is simply insane. The only solution for your opponents would be to focus you down as quickly as possible, but that's easier said than done because all you need to do is stay at max range and kite them around. The numbers in late-game teamfights are naturally even more ridiculous, as you will have more items, more shielding and ability power, and even more ability haste. Look how Kai'Sa is capped at max health despite getting jumped on by Zac, and how Senna's heals and shields turn this engage onto the allied AD carry into a solid 2-for-1 trade and a free dragon. Passive Moonstone healing in this fight alone? Yeah, 1,300. The tool Madrockt is probably using best is Senna's ultimate though. With all your ability power and shielding increase from enchanter items, this spell can win games by itself if you cast it efficiently. In this match, Madrockt's team is actually extremely far behind as the 17 kills Viego on the enemy team has been 1v9ing for the entire time. But with the help of an enchanter Senna's ultimate, Madrockt's team finally manages to collect that huge shutdown gold and eventually turn the game around. Landing these clutch ultimates is actually quite easy if you position yourself correctly. Senna's R hitbox that allows you to damage enemies might be rather narrow, but the area of effect in which you can shield your allies is super wide. By staying in the back and kiting at max range, you should be easily able to apply your big shield onto all 5 members of your team. As long as you're not pretending to be a frontline champion, you should be fine. Concerning your general playstyle and macro after the lane phase, Madrockt always makes sure to stay close to a, preferably fed, teammate. This allows him to immediately start applying his buffs if a fight breaks out, while at the same time getting him free soul stacks as his ally farms minions. He usually stays around mid lane because this is the juiciest area to set up vision control for his team. If his ally roams, he roams with them and looks for ways to deep ward the enemy jungle. He goes for the standard Q-max and picks Ignite and Flash for his summoner spells in most cases. If his lane partner doesn't get the summoner heal, he takes it instead of Ignite. The full rune page Madrockt uses in every single game is Guardian, Shield Bash, Bone Plating and Revitalize, with Futures Market and Cosmic Insight secondary. Shield Bash is mediocre, but simply the best choice for more 2v2 power in the lane phase, as you can get at least some value out of it even without your ultimate due to Guardian. Cosmic Insight allows you to always come out ahead when you trade summoner spells with the enemy, as it lowers your summoner spell cooldowns a little bit. Additionally, you get more trinket wards in lane, and later on more uptime on your sweeper due to the extra item haste. His shards are ability haste, adaptive force and armor. The typical item set for Guardian Senna is Moonstone Renewer first, then Ionian Boots of Lucidity, and finally Redemption and Ardent Censer. If the matchup calls for it, Madrokht will buy Mikhail's Blessing instead of Redemption. Both of these items further benefit from Cosmic Insight, by the way. Now, the secret thing Madrokht also does when playing this build is leaving a like on this video, and he would probably suggest that you click the link on your screen to polish up your knowledge about the most important Senna mechanics. Good luck, have fun, and happy climbing!